and this we already discussed, chi square test. I'm sure all of you now able to make a wise choice on when to use one sample Z test, one sample T test, two sample T test, ANOVA, one proportion test, two proportion test, chi square. How many testing you have understood so far? Seven different hypothesis testing. Now moving on. Test of variance. So all of you know variance. Variance is the square of standard deviation. Variance is square of standard deviation. See, when you are comparing two groups, your comparison should be a fair comparison. You studied two machines, machine number one and machine number two. Whatever condition you select, you collect data from machine number one. Under the same condition, you must collect data from machine number two. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
If you don't maintain that, sometime what happened? The average might be equal, but reality may not be equal. Am I correct? That is possible, right? I collect data different two different condition. At number one average and machine number two average are same. But when I look at every single data, that can differ, largely from the average. And so what your mean is speaking, it may not be the reality. So in order to trust the mean, you should know upfront what is the variance in your data. If variances are less, your mean can speak better. If your mean is speaking better, means the confidence interval is narrow. If the mean is not speaking better, that means your confidence interval will get widened. Whether your mean is going to give you a wider confidence interval or a narrower confidence interval, that depends on the variance in the data, right? So before conducting the test of mean, you must conduct a test of variance. The requirement is variances should be equal. When you are doing a two sample t-test, make sure the variances are equal. But if it is unequal, we will tweak the formula, and then there is a procedure to conduct the test. But the requirement is variances should be equal. When you are doing the ANOVA, variances should be equal. So whether the variances are equal or unequal, you have test of variance. You can study two groups, you can study more than two groups. When you are studying the variance of two groups, there are three options: F test, Bonnet's test, Levine's test. See, once you understand the basic, you can conduct any test. In fact, Minitab will do all the tests for you. You learn one hypothesis testing thoroughly, you are master of all the hypothesis testing. You really don't have to worry about the formula and everything, because those are developed by the gurus in statistics. You no need to be a guru again for what is already known. You can be a guru for something which is new. So trust their formulas, use it, and then you get your decision. So use the F test is generally powerful when your data are normally distributed. You compare the variance of two groups, your data are normally distributed. When your data, you can study the variance. If your data are normally distributed, use the F test. But if the distribution is skewed, and your distribution is skewed, then you can go for Bonnet test or Levine's test. Understand the equality of the variance. And within Bonnet test and Levine's test, Bonnet is powerful than Levine when your sample has more than 20 observation. And your sample has more than 20 observation, and distribution is not heavily skewed. Distribution is skewed, but not heavily. Prefer to use Levine's test when you have lower samples, not less than 20, and distribution is heavily skewed, right? So all of them are two variance tests only. When your data is normal, no confusion, go to F test. Not normal, two option, depending on how abnormal the distribution is. The distribution is too much abnormal, go for the Levine's test. Moderately skewed, and if you have more than 20, Bonnet test. See, ultimately, we want to go close to the reality. If distribution is normal, you will go very close. Abnormal situation is tough. You can't even understand the distribution, then you can't do anything. You are in complete dark, complete uncertainty. The world is like that. You can't predict everything very perfectly. Certain things there is certainty, that in certain things there is lot of uncertainty. When the certainty comes, once the distribution is understood, certainty comes. You can do a better forecasting, you can predict well. But when your data doesn't follow any of the distribution, I think in my opinion there are about 90 plus distribution available. If it doesn't fit into any of the distribution, then it is a complete uncertainty. Like the Bermuda Triangle, if you go there, people not able to understand what is happening, something like that, right? So we are trying to go closer and then understand better. So there are different routes. And then when there are more than two groups, that is called a test of equal variance. You have two options, multiple comparison test or Levine's test. Both can be used. Now, for the same problem which I told you already, you are manufacturing some in-home heater. The heater works, working with an electric damper, another one is working with a thermal damper, and ultimately you are interested in the energy consumption, right? The energy consumption for the electric data is, electric damper is available, energy consumption for the thermal damper is available, and you wanted to compare the variance in the data of the electric damper and the variance in the data of the thermal damper. The variances are equal. Variances are equal means you are equal or unequal. You are studying means it's a two variance test. The two variance test will become a F test if the data are normal. The two variance test will become a Bonnet test or Levine's test if data is skewed. And the study will be specifically Bonnet if the number of samples are more than 20. If it is less than 20, Levine's test. Is that clear?
Yeah.
Done. And more than two groups, what is the study called? Variance test. More than two, multiple comparison, or
Levine's test.
Levine's test can be used in more than two also. Good. Now you are good with test of mean, test of proportion, as well as test of what is called variance. Now non-parametric test. See, there are so many testing, we are not going to discuss everything. But you should know a non-parametric test exists. And now median is a non-parametric data. Right? Whenever your distribution is not normal, right, skewed, then non-parameters can speak better. For example, if I ask all of you to come on video, and I could see already, Alok with the blue color shirt in the photo, and Kamala Kannan with the blue color shirt in the photo, and then I can't understand Magesh which color he wears, right? So if I see so many people wearing a blue color shirt, what does it mean? Let's say out of 20 people, 18 people wear the blue color shirt. Now, what is this number called? Mode. Am I right? Blue color appear in 18 occasion out of the 20. Now, mode is helping me to understand the population. People like wearing blue color shirt. That's the behavior of the population, particularly on a Saturday. So sometimes your non-parametric data can help you understand the population, right? So median also, when your data contains so many outliers, when your data is just an ordinal data, but not a interval or a ratio scale, median can speak better about the population. Median can be the best representative of the central tendency. So when you want to determine whether the median of a sample differs significantly from a reference value, that is called one sample sign test. If you want to determine whether the median of a sample differs significantly from the specified value over and above, your data is symmetric. It's not normal, but it is cement. At that time, one sample Wilcoxon test will help you. And Whiteley test. Determine whether the median of two groups differ significantly. Right? Instead of two means, now it is two median. And Mann-Whiteley test. Use it when both data follow similar distribution. Both follow similar distribution, right? But both may be skewed. And now, crucial Wallis test. Determine whether the median of two or more group differs significantly. Use when all data follow similar distribution. Two or more, you can understand. So, crucial Wallis can be a replacement to Mann-Whiteley, but Mann-Whiteley cannot be used in the place of crucial Wallis. And then determine whether median of two or more group differ significantly, but the different groups follow different distribution, not similar distribution. That time, Mode's median test. Do you get an idea of what is non-parametric test and what is parametric test?
Yes.
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 So hypothesis testing helps in deciding whether a factor is critical or not. Ultimately, we want to get this question answered. Hypothesis testing becomes the basis for designed experiment and mathematical modeling. When you are creating a mathematical model, when you are creating a regression equation, you should add only the factors that are really critical. Am I correct? Yes. There is no point in creating an equation with all irrelevant factors. Your mathematical model cannot help you to understand the reality. So the input to the regression, input to the design of experiments and is derived from the outcome of the hypothesis testing, right? It becomes the basis. Adding non-critical factors may make your model will lag in terms of the fit. Lack of fit. Most of the time, when you create a mathematical model, one important thing you need to look at it is lack of fit. Lack of fit, significance of lack of fit should be understood. If the lack of fit is significant, it simply means the factors considered are irrelevant to the output you are trying to optimize. And so your paper may not be accepted and your research may not produce a proper finding if your model lacks in terms of fit. So if you generate a report from Minitab, Minitab will also talk about the significance for the lack of fit. It should not be significant. That means p-value should be more. Otherwise, what will happen? It will cause inaccuracy and then it will increase your experimental cost because you are spending your money with the wrong irrelevant factors. Right. So let me give you a simple example how hypothesis testing is conducted, how certain calculations are made. But anyway, with the complicated cases, Dr. R.K. will discuss. And now I have written a hypothesis statement here. H0 means is it null or